All of us heard about Laika, who was the first dog sent into orbit by the Soviet space program in 1957. But how about the experimental animal space program, who was ongoing since 1946 when United States started to use high-altitude balloons with small animals on board, making tests and experiments for radiation exposure, physiological response, or life support and recovery. Those high-altitude balloons reach a maximum altitude of only 27 miles, an altitude too low for the experiments to be concluding, especially those related to the radiation exposure. US wanted more. US wanted to reach the suborbital space to make more advanced experiments, so a rocket will be needed to reach an altitude of at least 66 miles above the ground, enough height from where the true space begins. Since the space era was at its uprise, the solution came directly from US Army. After the end of World War II, US Army seized an important number of German V-2 ballistic rockets designed by the Nazis during the World War II. The famous V-2 rockets could hit the target 200 miles away at a top speed of 3,500 miles per hour. The potential of scientific research in the field was high enough to use them as a solution for reaching the space. The first tests started at White Sand Missile Range in New Mexico. In 1946, a few V-2 rockets had been launched into space carrying biological samples on board, mostly seeds of corn and other plants. The V-2 rockets were powerful enough to reach an altitude of 80 miles above the ground, making them the perfect choice for NASA to reach the space zone. After a few success launches, NASA set a step further and started to conduct the necessary tests to send some animals into space. That was at the end of 1946. On February 20, 1947, a V-2 rocket carrying fruit flies has been launched from White Sand Missile Range. The rocket traveled at an altitude of 67 miles above the Earth, reaching the point where officially the space begins, making those small fruit flies the first animals who traveled into space. After the upright flight, the rocket capsule descended back to Earth with the help of a braking parachute. The scientists were very pleased to see that the flies are still alive after opening the donut capsule. After a few tests, the scientists concluded that the cosmic radiation had no genetic effect on those flies. They conducted new experiments on primates, and on 14 June 1949, US launched another V-2 rocket, this time carrying the first primate on board, named Albert II, a monkey from rhesus species. Albert II was the first monkey who reached the space at an altitude of 83 miles. Unfortunately, Albert II died on Earth impact due to a parachute deploying failure, making him the first casualty of a space program. On 31 August 1950, NASA launched another V-2 rocket into space at an altitude of 82 miles above the ground, carrying another living creature, this time was a mouse. Same problem happened as in case of Albert II, the capsule disintegrated in there, killing the small mouse because the parachute failed to deploy. On 22 July 1951, the Soviet Union launched the R-1A1 spaceflight, carrying on board two dogs, Tsigan and Desik, into space, but not into orbit. These two dogs were the first living higher organism successfully recovered from a spaceflight. Both space dogs survived the flight, although one will die shortly after from some heart problems.